fam, I'm back. I wrote a poem just a little while ago called Fill This Vessel. Backdrop of it is that there's two women on my job that I let get under my skin. I think they're trying to set me up. Why? I have no idea. Like, I don't even get it. But they've been there for 4 years. I've been there for 2 months. So, but whatever. So I was kind of like thrown off by them and very upset and didn't handle it the right way in my mind. Not to them. I didn't disrespect them or anything like that to their faces. And then me and one of my children, all my children are grown, but one of my children, she and I got into it, and she said some things, I said some things that I know I shouldn't say. And no matter what she said, I shouldn't have let myself say what I said, because I'm accountable for me. She's accountable for her, and I'm accountable for me. So in going through that, I did some self-inventory, and I'm like, God, you know what? I need you to empty this vessel and then fill me again, but fill me with your love, your kindness, your mercy, your grace, everything you got, like your love just overall. Like, even when people do me wrong, I need to at least walk in God's will and show them, like, in short, what would Jesus do, right? So, so that's kind of where this poem birthed from me doing self-inventory and realizing that I need God to fill this vessel, like, with his will, not mine. So before I start, I want you to hear what this Bishop Francis says, and then I'm going to say my prayer and go into the poem. So here you go. I'm sure you couldn't hear that because I had it down too low. Sorry. He said, "It is only through the power in the blood of Jesus that a man can experience change and transformation." So that's where I am. So when I heard that, it kind of hit me. It stuck. So may the words of my mouth and a meditation of my heart be pleasing in your sight. No further ado, fill this vessel. God, I come before you as a full vessel. However, I'm not full of all righteousness, and this is why I wrestle. I want to be more like you every day, hour to hour, but alone, God, I cannot do it. I need your power. I need you to help clean me out and then fill me up again with everything that your love's about. My ways are a sickness, and I'm constantly feeling ill. God, in me, please make it that it's your will that I fulfill. I got angry a couple days with two of my coworkers, and I didn't walk in love. I would have been arrested if my coworkers knew what I was thinking of. I got home and my child rubbed me the wrong way. I said some things that I know I shouldn't say. I don't want to hurt anyone's walk with my actions. That's why I need you, God. I need to emulate your compassion. God, I say I'll do better as I'm praying in my bed. But when I get up sometimes that quickly, other thoughts fill my head because I hear, think, or see something and I'm thrown off track. I need your guidance, God, to bring me back. I know that I will not be perfect, but I want to do more of what's right. I want you to reduce me so people see your light. Please make me an empty vessel and then fill me up again. Remove my pride, greed, lust, envy, gluttony, anger, sloth, and any of my other sins. See, I know this walk is not promised to be easy. However, help me to stop doing things that only please me, because I know that's not your will. Your humility, patience, kindness, charity, temperance, your love is what in me I want you to instill. I want to be more and more like you. And I realize that it's a process that I have to go through. It's about self-discipline, self-control, obedience, and living your word. I need you most when by iniquity, my submission to you is blurred. I need to hear you and it needs to be clear so that I'm not confused. And like Elijah, it's just still small voice that I can hear. Please remove all that's in me that shouldn't be. Please make me an empty vessel so that you can pour into me. And then what you pour in me to others, I can pour out as I continue to fill. God, with your love, your compassion, as you fill my vessel, is really what this prayer is all about.
Again, I need you to change me, oh, change.